Now, as we just witnessed with Chris jumping up and down on the picnic tables, yes, in fact, we had 7 correct exposures. Yet, visually, radically different, particularly at the faster speeds versus the very slow shutter speeds. What I'm about to show you now, too, is the same thing applies when it comes to the aperture. My point being is this. We're going to take a picture of this hibiscus against the backdrop of this resort. The important part to keep in mind is this. I'm once again going to shoot 7 correct exposures. And the reason I'm shooting 7 correct exposures as opposed to you might being able only to shoot 6 is because my lens goes to a maximum lens opening of 2.8. Yours perhaps only goes to f4. But we both will finish up at 22. So keep in mind, as you look at these photographs, they are all exactly the same in terms of their quantitative value. That is to say, simply, they are a correct exposure. Yet keep your eye on the background, because with every reduction in aperture opening from 4 to 5, 6 to 8 to 11, we are actually increasing what is called depth of field. And that's the role that aperture plays when it comes to creative exposure. If you want a great deal of depth of field, you need to be spending your time in the double-digit apertures, such as 22 or 16. If you want minimal, if any, depth of field, you need to be spending your time at the smaller numbers, like 2.8 or 4. And then there are those times when it really doesn't matter, what I affectionately call who cares apertures. Who cares what aperture I use? If you find yourself in that situation, and I'll show you some examples in a moment, you would definitely want to be using the apertures of 8 and 11. Why? Because optically, they, generally speaking, offer up the greatest color, contrast, and sharpness. Let's go to the camera and see what we're doing. Right now, I'm looking at this hibiscus, framing it accordingly. I'm at an aperture of f4. My shutter speed says a 4,000th of a second with 200 ISO will give me a correct exposure. So I shoot it. I move to 5.6 at a 2,000th, take it again. I move to f8 at a 1,000th, meter says that's correct. I go to f11, I go to a 500th, meter says once again, that's also correct. I go to 16, shoot it at a 250th, meter says, yeah, that's correct. I go to 22, and finally at a 1/25th, the meter says, no problem, that's correct. And as you can see, they are all correct exposures. But are they all creatively correct exposures? And again, by creative, I mean the creative use of the aperture. Clearly, at least in my view, those images taken around 4 to 5, 6 render the hibiscus flower as it should be rendered, in my opinion, which is it's the trophy shot. It's like, hey, look at me. There's nothing else to distract you. Yet, in the same correct exposure we shot at 16 or 22, that same hibiscus, it is correctly exposed, but now it has to compete with the background. It's kind of like the news camera person, or the news anchor person who's doing a live report, and in the background there's that kid jumping, hey, look at me, look at me. That's a distracting background. Yes, it's a correct exposure, but not the creatively correct exposure that we're wanting. Again, in this instance, that would be down at the f4 to 5.6 range. Here's my point. As you approach a given subject, you need to ask yourself 3 things. Is there a motion opportunity here? If so, is it freezing action, implying motion, or maybe you want to pan it? Another 3 things. No, that doesn't exist, you say. Okay, well then do you have depth of field concerns? If so, you want to be at the double digits, 22 or 16. No, I don't care. Well, then you can use 8 or 11. Or if you want to isolate, as I've done here with this flower, you need to be at the 4 to 5, 6 range. I hope this is finally coming together for you. Yes, you can take a correct exposure, but your goal is to shoot a creatively correct exposure. In other words, what's the most creative and yet still correct exposure to shoot? Keep that in the forefront of your mind, and I guarantee you, you'll have much, much greater success. Until next time, this is Brian Peterson saying, keep shooting.